Sir, presiding at today's proceedings, Dr. Shankar Acharya, Dr. Kirit Parikh, keynote speakers, Shri Vibhas Kumar, former Cabinet Secretary and President for the IC Centre for Governance, Shri M.K. Kao, former Secretary HRD, Government of India, and member of the core group of the IC Centre for Governance, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. As we proceed towards the close of today's event, it is my privilege and pleasure to propose a vote of thanks on behalf of the IC Centre for Governance. In the first instance, our profuse thanks to our two honoured guests and keynote speakers, Dr. Kirit Parikh and Dr. Shankar Acharya. They have taken time out from their busy schedule to share their thoughts and views on the important topic of managing subsidies. And the expenditure part was got left out, and we'll probably have another lecture for it, as mentioned by the previous. In our lecture series on financial sector reforms, both Dr. Acharya and Dr. Parikh are experts in the domain of public finance based on their qualifications, experience and assignments. I am sure all of us have benefited from their insights and knowledge of the subject of public financial management in the context of the complexities of India's economy and also of its polity. Thank you very much, sir. We are grateful to Dr. Anandi Gupta, Professor Emeritus for Economics, IIM Ahmedabad, and an expert on public finance, for his insightful remarks and also for chairing this very interesting session. Professor Gupta, as a member of our core group, often enlightens us through the spoken and written word on the intricacies of public finance domain. Thank you, Anandi. My also thanks Shri M.K. Kao for his introductory remarks and setting the tone for the following proceedings. Shri Kao, inter alia, Principal Secretary of Finance in the State Government of Himachal Pradesh and Member Secretary of 5th Pay Commission, has had considerable experience in the domain of public finance. Thank you, sir, for your valuable comments. I would also like to add our words of gratitude to our President Shri Prabhat Kumar for his valuable guidance in all the activities and events of the IC Centre for Governance. We look forward for his continued stewardship of the Centre. Our thanks are also due to Shri B.D. Gupta, who is not present today, Vice President ICCCF, and a member of its core group for coordinating the organization of these lectures, and to Shri J.S. Oberoi, former Vice President, for his welcome address, humor et al. I have added these words. Before concluding, I may refer to one or two aspects relevant to the subject of today's lecture. First is a quote from the editorial section of yesterday's Times of India. While disapproving the point yesterday raised by you, probably he has a different opinion. While disapproving of the raising of duties on petrol and diesel twice in a month in the face of a sharp fall in international crude prices, it is stated, and I quote, "For sure, the government is under financial pressure on account of a disappointing performance in tax collection. However, it has not tried hard enough to curb its expenses," you mentioned. "Token cuts are simply not enough. Given the myriad schemes that have been floated over the years to serve the purpose of political messaging, there is a strong case for considerably rationalizing of expenses." Arun Jaitley has promised a re-look at subsidy policies, and the current benign global situation is the best time to do it, unquote. The reputed economists on the dais would agree that it is not an easy task. In what we have often say and hear, inverted Indian conditions, and the call given by the All India Labour Unions, which I heard only recently, for a strike to protest against some of the government reforms and policy moves, both actual and proposed, is a pointer to the arduous road ahead. In the larger context of public policy domain, I would like to quote an extract from the blurb on the inner flap of a recent book, "Politics Trumps Economics: The Interface of Economics and Politics in Contemporary India," edited by Dr. Bimal Jalan, and Kulupre Balakrishna. And I quote, "In India, a globally impressive talent pool coexists with the highest incidence of poverty in the world. The engaged citizen is aware of this situation, wants to know how it has come about and what can be done to improve it. That the country's full potential is not being realized to make for a dynamic economy," which Dr. Saab just mentioned about that, "and acceptable living conditions for her people points to something beyond economics being at play. And this is the ever-present politics," unquote. "The time has come for good economics combined with good governance to trump bad politics, which is largely holding back the country's transformation." And now, last but not least, I have the pleasure in thanking the distinguished audience for their presence and participation at today's session on expenditure and subsidies management. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.